Okay guys, welcome to ITS, Information Technology Skills. So for today's video, we're going to have logic formulation, which starts with flowcharting. This is the lesson 3 of our Introduction to Computer Programming. So let's begin. What is a flowchart? A flowchart is a graphical representation of a sequence of operations. A flowchart contains a symbol describing how an algorithm or a program operates. So the example of flowchart is this. So basically guys, ang flowchart, they are graphical representation or images that represents the sequence or yung arrangement ng isang operation. Then ang flowchart, ginagamitan po natin niya ng different symbols or shapes which will be discussed for the next slide para ma-represent niya po yung operation. Okay, what are the symbols used in flowchart? So for the symbols, we have the following: terminal block, process block, input or output block, decision block, initialization block, connector, and flow lines. Flow lines indicate by straight line with arrow to show the directions of data. So basically, ang flow lines guys, they are line with an arrowhead para maipakita po kung saan yung direction or ano yung next step na pupuntahan ng data. Used to connect blocks by exiting from one and entering from another. Okay, so if you're going to look at the image, that is an example of flow line. Terminal block. Ovals or rounded rectangles are used to indicate the start and the end of the module or a program. Okay, so from the word terminal block, ito po yung symbol na ginagamit para sa termination or start ng ating algorithm or flowchart. Okay, so we have two, yung start and the end. So basically, from the word start, yun po magsisimula yung flowchart, and the end is the last or the ending point of the flowchart. So don't forget guys, ang flowchart is an algorithm. Graphical representation po siya. Kaya dapat po meron tayong end. The next, we have the initialization block. Used to declare or initialize variables needed to store a certain process. So we have the word declare. So declaration, stating a variable name to be used. Then we have initializing. Initialization, to set a starting value of a variable. So ano pinag-iba ng declaration and initialization? Pag sinabi nating declaration, you're just stating the name. Sinasabi mo lang kung ano yung mga kailangan. For example, magbe-bake ka ng cake. Ang declaration dun, sasabihin mo kailangan mo ng flour, ng egg, ng milk, ng water, pero walang amount. For the initialization, sasabihin mo kung ano yung kailangan mong ingredients plus the amount. Okay? So, for example, initialize mo yung sa baking, masasabihin mo, kailangan mo ng flour, 3 cups, egg, 3 eggs, water, 1 liter. Okay? That is initialization. Sasabihin mo kung anong kailangan mo plus the value. Okay? So, to further explain to you, meron tayo ng next slide. So, this is an example of declaration. If you're going to observe, meron lang tayong num1 and num2. Wala silang value. Sinasabi mo lang na kailangan mo yan later on dun sa process ng algorithm mo. Then next, the initialization. For the initialization, meron na po siyang value or meron siyang laman. Sinasabi mo na kailangan mo for num1 is 5, for num2 is 3. So, that's the difference between the two. Okay, the next, we have the process block. Rectangle indicates a process block. Okay, so the symbol used for process block is rectangle. you for such thing as calculations, opening and closing files, and so on. Okay, so from the word process block, ito po yung processes or actions na ginagawa natin. So we have this example of process block. So meron tayo ng num1 and num2 kanina. We want to calculate their sum. Kung gusto nating makuha yung sum nilang dalawa. So we have here sum equals to num1 plus num2. Okay guys, don't forget na isa lang yung enter and exit point ng process block. The next, we have the input and output block. The parallelogram indicates input or output operations. Okay, it is parallel. Okay, so this is an example of input and output block. Okay, so you're going to observe the input. Meron siyang get x. Okay, for the input, you can use the verb get, enter, input. Okay, so those are the variables or verb that can use inside input block. And for the output block, you can use the verb display and print. The next, we have the decision block. The diamond indicates decision. Okay, so the symbol or the shape being used for decision block is diamond. It has one entrance and exactly two exit from the block. One exit is the action when the resultant is true and the other is false. Okay, so for the decision block, we have this. Okay, if you're going to observe, isa lang po yung arrow na papunta sa condition. Okay. A condition, guys, are questions or statements that gives you an answer of true or false or yes or no. So, yung mga condition natin are questions or statement. Nasasagutan ka or bibigyan ka ng sagot na true or false, yes or no. An example is, magka-IT ba ako? Yes or no? Masaya bang IT? Yes or no? Okay? So, that is a condition. Then, next, if you're going to look at the decision block, meron po siyang dalawang exit point, which is the true or false. Okay, so, for the true or false, it can be any symbol. It can be a process block, input-output block, or terminal block. So, later on, madi-discuss natin yan. Okay, so the conventions or the questions that can be answered or given under conditions, we have true or false, T or F, that is the same with true or false, yes or no, Y or N, same with yes or no. Then next, we have the connectors. The circle is used as a connection point between two sections of flowchart. They are not adjacent or closely located to each other. Okay guys, ginagamit yung connectors para i-connect yung mga blocks na medyo magkalayo. Okay, so for example, you are writing or nagsusulat ka ng flowchart mo, then hindi siya nagkasya sa papel or dun sa pinagsusulatan mo. So, gagamit ka ngayon ng connector para may connect mo yung dugtong ng flowchart mo dun sa ibang part ng papel. Okay, but we have this note. Okay, connector should be used as little as possible. So, as much as possible, dapat hindi tayo gumagamit ng connector. Okay, this should only be used to enhance readability. So, ginagamit lang siya para malinis siya tignan. Kasi, syempre, yung pangit naman kapag ang dami mong lines na paikot-ikot, hindi po siya tulad ng puzzles. However, decreases readability and produce cluttered effect. Okay? So, mayroon siyang however. Mayroon din siyang negative effect pag parating ginagamit yung connector. So, that's it guys. It ends the session for today. Please don't forget to watch the next video kasi gagawa po tayo din ng flow chart and some problems na pwede po natin gawin with flow chart. Okay, so please don't forget to subscribe to this video or this channel. Click this video, hit the notification bell for more tutorial videos.